Okay, it's time to change the oil on the new CB500X Rally Raid Adventure Bike with the Rally Raid engine guard installed on the bike. We're going to find out together how easy or how difficult this is to do. The points of service are very simple. The drain plug is located back here. The engine filter located on the front of the engine. We're going to fill the oil right here, 2.9 quarts. We've got 3 quarts of oil. And we're going to check the level of the oil right here at the sight glass. Now the procedure for doing this is we're going to drop this guard right here to get access to our filter. And we're going to drop the engine guard itself right here at the rear mounting point and lower the engine guard down just a little bit so we can get access to the drain plug. We're going to leave the guard attached here. Do not take the guard apart here, as that is very, as you saw from the installation video, this frame will spring forward slightly on you, and it's a real chore to get these bolts installed without cross-threading them. So we're going to pivot here and remove it at the rear point. Might be a little messy. We might get some of this engine oil from the filter on the inside of this bash plate, so we'll do the job out here in the dirt using a proper drain pan. We'll dispose of all oil properly. Let's take a look at the manual and see what it has to say. Take a quick look at page 43 here in the manual and you'll understand why you want to buy a Honda. Look at the frequency on some of this stuff. Very few moving parts. Oil change is recommended every 8,000 miles. Oil and filter, or once a year. Valves, valve clearance, inspected at 16,000 miles after the initial inspection. Replace the spark plug every 16,000 miles. Air cleaner, recommended 12,000 miles. Now, that's something else we might talk about today. The air cleaner is a paper cleaner. I don't know of an oil dirt bike kind of substitute yet air filter for this bike. So it's a paper air filter. It's only about 19 bucks at the Honda dealer. I'm just going to get another one and replace it. And you're going to want to do that at a much more higher frequency than the recommended 12,000 miles if you're operating this thing in dirt and dusty conditions like I am. And one other item is the crankcase breather, which we'll show you. Looks like every 4,000 miles, get in there and clean that. It's just a plug on the end of a hose. Radiator coolant's good for 24,000 miles before you replace it. Brake fluid, replace at 12,000 miles. Everything else is inspect and repair as necessary. That's why we like the Honda. Very low maintenance. So for the job, I got 3 quarts of my favorite Honda engine oil, just regular old mineral oil, GN4, 1030 weight as recommended in the book there, and a genuine Honda filter, looks like a 15410 MFJ D01 with a new crush washer for the drain plug. With an 8mm socket and a 10mm wrench, we'll pull the guard covering the oil filter. Custom Rally Raid guard. Just loosen this one. There we go. Off she goes. You know, in fact, you probably just loosen all of those and then pull this off without having to completely remove all the hardware. And note two, still no dings yet on those headers, and that includes the, well, we gotta wait and see how John Mitchison makes it through the Simpson Desert on his Australian prototype CB500X. Let's see if he's put any dents in these headers yet. Jenny had no trouble at all with her 15,000 mile Transamerica Trail trip across America. People are wondering how sturdy these exposed headers are going to be on this design. Okay, now let's drop the rear the Rally Raid engine guard by removing this 8mm bolt right here. There's a 10mm wrench is going to be needed for the nut on the back. See if we can rotate this a little so we can get access to this point. Okay, now I'm able to work a screwdriver in behind here and gently persuade this thing out. Now, remember, you hopefully grease this up a little bit when you installed the bash plate in the first place. Some of this anodized paint may be a tight fit on here as well. Here comes this kick. All right, now. There you go, just push it down. All right, so no, you don't need to loosen these here. You can just drop it down right there. Now we've got access to the drain plug right there. Easy access. Now it's a little messy. Maybe we'll try a little tin foil catch basin and move this whole operation over onto the gravel so we don't mess up our fine concrete. I think in the future, Rally Raid is going to leave this portion of the pin unpainted so that it fits a little looser, a little easier into the mount. Popping it out will be a real piece of cake then. So I fashioned a sort of tinfoil scupper to drain the oil, hopefully cleanly, from the drain plug into the pan, and possibly even from the filter into the pan. We'll see how that works up there. I don't know with the head or all. Anyways, 12mm socket on the drain plug itself. Get it busted loose. Let's see how big a mess we make. Let's watch this. We already got the engine all good and warmed up. Ready? There she goes. Perfect. Oh, piece of cake. Yeah, that's right. So even Jenny said that. It squirts right out past the guard initially, and then it'll start draining into the guard. I'll pop the filler plug too. There. That catches the tinfoil and works just like planned. Brilliant! Let's crack this loose too so it breathes. Okay, now let's see how big a mess we can make with the oil filter itself. Not sure where it's all squirting out of yet. I think it's going right into the tinfoil as per planned. One H oil filter. Draining into the tinfoil. The last little bit of old oil out of here if you can. If you want to drop your Rally Raid guard down further, it looks like this tab here is going to hit the header pipes, preventing you from dropping it down any lower, which is fine. That's all you need right there. And again, I didn't have to loosen these up one bit to do this. When we do put this back together, I'm going to recheck the torque on these bolts just to make sure they haven't spun any while we did this procedure. Here's the torque values from the oil draining procedure in your owner's manual, page 66. Looks like the oil filter, they like to see that torque to 19 foot-pounds, and the oil filter drain bolt, 22 foot-pounds. Get the new crush washer for the drain plug. Let's get the oil drain plug back in with the new washer and torque to specs. Taste of the old engine oil or the new rubber gasket for the new filter. Add a little new oil to our new oil filter. Just to kind of help prevent cavitation when you first start up the engine. Put torque that this way. The main thing is don't over torque these oil filters.
Little bit of hurt on it.
Just like that.
Okay, let's clean up our tin foil scupper drain. And
I don't know if that scupper drain's even worth it. We still got a little bit of oil to clean up.
See, the bash plate's already been doing a little bit of work, saving the drip pan and the correction, saving the oil sump and the catalytic converter. Rotate the bash plate back into position, and I notice while it's rotating,
while it was rotating, the forward engine bolts were not rotating. We'll still double check that torque anyways.
Insert the rally raid pin.
Clean and add a little fresh grease to your pin, your rear pin, rear mounting pin. And get it back in there. Now, you might consider sanding that a little, or it still fits pretty nice. It's a little tight there, yeah. You might consider sanding some of that anodized paint off of there for an easier fit. Yeah, that's fine. And bolt it back together. Insert the bolt and nut. And washer. Just that easy. And start adding new oil. We'll add most of the 3 quarts, fire it up, run it, and then top it off according to the sight glass. Put the filler cap back on, fire it up, and check for leaks. Pumping in there. Put the rally raid oil filter guard back in place. And then we're just going to top it off using the sight glass to the last of the 2.9 quarts. A little bit on the high sides. Right about there. That should do it. Good for a year. One other thing to check during oil change is this crankcase breather plug. It pulls right off of there. Check that's free and clear of any sludge or buildup. This is like brand new. And a pair of long nose, needle nose pliers works good to get that plug in and out of there.
Check out the project, man.
There he comes. You're just in time. The work's all done, man.
Perfect timing.
Perfect timing. All I need to get now is the beer. Yeah. Look at this beast. Wow. That's the 650, right?
Yeah, the R.
R? So Mark, it probably is about the same size height-wise as me. He's gonna try it out. Tippy toes, yeah, yeah. Yeah, how tall do you think you are?
5'9", 5'10".
5'9", all right. Yeah.
That's about what
you do, tippy toes? Yep, just yeah. About exactly the same. I got the 31-inch short boy inseam.
That's kind of how that is.
Yeah, we'll go take it for a hop around the patch, man.
Yeah.
Very conventional, yeah. Quiet, huh? Yeah, sewing machine. Yeah, this is just kind of the reverse concept. A Honda dirt bike turned into a street bike, or a super motard. The street tires, the small front wheel. Hooligan! 650 single thumper, yeah. 650R. Look at that big hefty brace. Well,
nice. Yeah, it's smooth.
Smooth, quiet, comfortable.
It is comfortable. I'm surprised, you know? Yeah. I can see I can put some miles on that.
Yeah, go all day, man. Yeah.
So you just got done riding this to the coast.
Uh-huh, and yeah. Back, yep.
Nice. Yeah, definitely I can see that could be a good cross-country bike.
Yeah, yep. Yeah, capable on the highways, you know, up to 80 miles an hour, still cruising comfortably.
Is that what it cruises at, pretty good?
Yeah, 6,500 yeah. RPM, so it's
up there.
Up there a little bit, yeah. Right. Yeah. It's only 471 cc's, and but then whatever you want to do on the trails.
All right.
The dirt roads or what have you.
Well, I think that kit you've done has really opened up
a lot more dirt capability.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure.
Pretty stiff on the stock setup.
I like the one finger brakes.
Yeah, those levers too help a lot with that.
Oh, okay. Are those adjustable?
Yep, adjustable levers. Nice. Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, I was just real impressed with the brakes.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought they were a little soft and weakish, but
Well. I'm used to 18-year-old technology.
Yeah.
You
know? Yeah. So there you go.
Yeah.
It's all relative.
It is.
I'm gonna pour that into here. Can you film me? Can you run the camera?
Okay. Uh-oh.
Can you say dispose of all oil properly?
The stop. What again?
Dispose of all oil.
Of all oil.
Properly.
Properly.
Can you say it one more time?
No.
Don't move. It'll spill all over.
I can't say it again.
Dispose of all oil properly.
Dispose of all purple oil properly. Dispose of all oil properly.
Good. Show it, that's going down the drain there. Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Say bye-bye to everybody, Pete.
Bye-bye.
No, over here on the camera.
Bye-bye?
Yes.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
There we go. Ow! Oh, I hate those channel locks. Ah! Remember last time I was cussing and swearing these pliers? God bless. The wrong tool for the wrong job, folks. Get a proper filter wrench. Don't be a cheap bastard like me.